There are certain things he said on the campaign which were not liked by a lot of people. But at the same time, he did not move away from
it. All right, we have a declaration there, more or less. U.S. House Speaker says Trump is our new president. The U.S. House Speaker declaring Trump is our new president. This is a word coming in from the United States House Speaker, where he says clearly that Trump is our new president. And of course, it's a confirmation that almost is established with the numbers that we see itself on our screens. Very telling. Donald Trump at 266 out of 270, with Kamala Harris at 188. A huge leap, a huge lead that Donald Trump has won by. And here you have the U.S. House Speaker who is declaring that Donald Trump is America's new president. Rohit, over to you.
2016, you recall what you said about Hillary Clinton. She's been through enough. There was a lot of pressure to prosecute her.
Rohit, if you can hear me, U.S. House Speaker says Trump is our new president. It's a declaration there. Donald Trump, remember, has spoken extensively and boldly about boosting the United States economy. That's been his the biggest poll plank as he campaigned extensively. He did speak on boosting the economy. The U.S. economy that seems to be in tatters the last few years has been difficult. So Donald Trump's focus on trade and policy extensively seems to have worked in his favor by and large. We're looking at Donald Trump there holding that sheet where he's reading out, possibly taking a last-minute glance of his victory speech. And in moments from now, he's going to be taking stage for that victory speech. Huge crowds has gathered right there in Florida at this event to celebrate Donald Trump's victory. If I can bring in Rohit for that. Rohit, a quick word on United States House Speaker who says Trump is our new president. Is that a declaration?
Well, Mike Johnson has been a supporter. He's a Republican. He's probably also looked at the same poll, same numbers. He's looked at Fox News and he said, you know what, if Fox is calling it, I might as well go ahead and do this. And you want to be in the good books of Donald Trump. You do not want to wait. You want to call him. You want to be around. I know for a fact that Vivek Ramaswamy is going to be there as well. He is in Florida and I was told that he will be on that stage as well. Elon Musk is already there as well. So all the people that have helped Donald Trump to become the next president will be there. Mike Johnson he was struggling with his speakership. Republicans had a lot of infighting and Donald Trump intervened and installed him as the next Speaker of the House. So it's not surprising at all that Mike Johnson would write something like this and issue a letter and say that, we've got a new president in the House and that's Donald Trump, the 47th president of the United States. So a lot of these moments will happen now, Nabila. We'll see a lot of things going on. Look, Elon Musk wants to open up a new office, the Department of, I think it's called DOGE, a governance enhancement or something like that. I forget what it is. So there will be a lot coming out from Washington, D.C. in the next few days. He hasn't really set up his transition team
yet. We're taking you through those live images of Donald Trump taking to the stage at an audience, in front of a huge audience there. Is that Ivanka Trump? All right, no, that's his wife. Donald Trump and his wife, likely the first lady here, who have taken to the stage. They're going to be speaking.
Thank you very much. Wow. Well, I want to thank you all very much. This is great. These are our friends. We have thousands of friends on this incredible movement. This was a movement like nobody's ever seen before. And frankly, this was, I believe, the greatest political movement of all time. There's never been anything like this in this country, and maybe beyond. And now it's going to reach a new level of importance because we're going to help our country heal. We're going to help our country heal. We have a country that needs help, and it needs help very badly. We're going to fix our borders. We're going to fix everything about our country. And we made history for a reason tonight, and the reason is going to be just that. We overcame obstacles that nobody thought possible, and it is now clear that we've achieved the most incredible political thing. Look what happened. Is this crazy? But it's a political victory that our country has never seen before, nothing like this. I want to thank the American people for the extraordinary honor of being elected your 47th president and your 45th president. And every citizen, I will fight for you, for your family, and your future. Every single day, I will be fighting for you, and with every breath in my body. I will not rest until we have delivered the strong, safe, and prosperous America that our children deserve and that you deserve. This will truly be the golden age of America. That's what we have to have. This is a magnificent victory for the American people that will allow us to make America great again. And in addition to having won the battleground states of North Carolina, I love these places, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin, we are now winning in Michigan, Arizona, Nevada, and Alaska, which would result in us carrying at least 315 electoral votes, but but it's much easier doing what the networks did or whoever called it, because there was no other path. There was no other path to victory. We also have won the popular vote. That was great. Very proud of it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. And, winning the popular vote was very nice. Very nice, I will tell you. It's a great feeling of love. We have a great feeling of love in this very large room with unbelievable people standing by my side. These people have been incredible. They've made the journey with me, and we're going to make you very happy. We're going to make you very proud of your vote. I hope that you're going to be looking back someday and say that was one of the truly important moments of my life when I voted for this group of people beyond the president, this group of great people. America has given us an unprecedented and powerful mandate. We have taken back control of the Senate. Wow, that's good. And the Senate races in Montana, Nevada, Texas, Ohio, Michigan, Wisconsin, the great Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, were all won by the MAGA movement. They helped so much. And in those cases, every one of them, we worked with the senators. They were tough races. And I mean, the number of victories in the Senate was absolutely incredible. And we did teller rallies. We did teller rallies with each one of them. And sometimes we did two or three for, and it was amazing to look at all of those victories. Nobody expected that, nobody. So I just wanted to thank you very much for that. And we have, you have some great senators and some great new senators. And it also looks like we'll be keeping control of the House of Representatives. And I want to thank Mike Johnson. I think he's doing a terrific job. Terrific job. I want to also thank my beautiful wife, Melania, First Lady. Who has the number one best-selling book in the country. Can you believe that? Oh, no, she's done a great job, works very hard to help people. So I just want to thank her. But I want to thank my whole family, my amazing children, and they are amazing children. Now, we all think our children are amazing. Everybody here thinks their children are amazing, but that's a good thing when you think they are. But Don, Eric, Ivanka, Tiffany, Barron, Laura, Jared, Kimberly, Michael, thank you all. What a help. What a great. My father-in-law, Victor, is tremendous. And we miss very much Melania's mother, Amalia. We miss Amalia, don't we, huh? She would be very happy right now, standing on this stage. She'd be so proud. She was a great woman, that one. Beautiful inside and out. She was a great woman. I want to be the first to congratulate our great, now I can say, Vice President-elect of the United States, J.D. Vance. And his absolutely remarkable and beautiful wife, Usha Vance. And he is a feisty guy, isn't he? You know, I've said, go into the enemy camp. And you know, the enemy camp is certain networks. And a lot of people don't like to, sir, do I have to do that? He just goes, okay. Which one? CNN, MSDNC? He'll say, all right, thank you very much. He actually looks fine. He's like the only guy I've ever seen. He really looks forward to it. And then he just goes in and absolutely obliterates them. Say a couple of words.
Wow. Well, Mr. President, I appreciate you allowing me to join you on this incredible journey. I thank you for the trust that you placed in me. And I think that we just witnessed the greatest political comeback in the history of the United States of America. And under President Trump's leadership, we're never going to stop fighting for you, for your dreams, for the future of your children. And after the greatest political comeback in American history, we're going to lead the greatest economic comeback in American history under Donald Trump's leadership.
Thank you very much. He's turned out to be a good choice. I took a little heat at the beginning, but he was, I knew the brain was a good one, about as good as it gets. And we love the family, and we're going to have a great 4 years, and we're going to turn our country around, make it something very special. It lost that. Lost that little. It lost that little. That little thing called special. We have to make it so. We're going to make this so great. It's the greatest country and potentially the greatest country in the world by far. And right now, we're going to just work very hard to get all of that back. We're going to make it the best it's ever been. We can do that. We just, if we had to wait longer, I don't know. It was going bad, and it was going bad fast. We're going to have to seal up those borders, and we're going to have to let people come into our country. We want people to come back in, but we have to let them come back in, but they have to come in legally. They have to come in legally. Let me also express my tremendous appreciation for Susie and Chris, the job you did. Susie, come here. Come here, Susie. Chris, come here, Chris. Susie likes to stay sort of in the back, let me tell you. The Ice Maiden, we call her the Ice Maiden. Come here, Chris. Come here, Chris. Come here, Chris. Susie likes to stay in the background. She's not in the background.
This was unexpected, but I just want to thank, obviously, President Trump for this journey. It was a great one, and he's a hell of a candidate, and he's going to be a hell of a great 47th president. And this team that we had, the best team, and, of course, even my boss, Susie Wiles, the best. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you, Susie. Look at this. I've never seen her be shot before. Susie, they're great. Everybody up here is great. Everybody up here is very special. But the Trump, who did you say? Oh, let me tell you, we have a new star. A star is born, Elon. Now he is. Now he's an amazing guy. We were sitting together tonight. You know, he spent 2 weeks in Philadelphia and different parts of Pennsylvania campaigning. You know, he sent the rocket up 2 weeks ago, and I saw that rocket, and I saw it coming down. I saw it. It was, when it left, it was beautiful, shiny white. When it came down, it didn't look so pretty. It was going 10,000 miles an hour, and it was burning like hell. I said, what happened to your paint job? He said, we've never made a paint that could withstand that kind of heat. And but I saw it come down and turn around. And it was, you know, it's like 22 stories tall, by the way. It looks a little smaller than that, but it's big. And it came down and down, and you saw that fire burning. And I'm saying, only Elon can do this. It must be an Elon. And I tell the story. I told it last night. I had a man on the phone. I had the screen muted, no sound. I was talking to a very important man, happens to be here, and that very important guy, one of the most important people in, I would say, the country, actually. But, you know, I was president, and now it looks like I was going to be maybe president again, so I figured I could ask him to hold. So I asked him to hold, and because, especially because you're going to be president again, they hold. So I took the phone down, and I'm looking at the screen. I'm seeing this crazy thing that's going around and coming down. It looks like it's going to crash into the gantry. And I said, oh, no. And I said, do me a favor. Do you mind holding for a couple of minutes? I want to see this.